Today we will see how to create this spinning loading animation using pure CSS, and animations like this comes in handy many times, so we'll quickly see how to make one. So saying that, let's get into the code. So we have our basic HTML skeleton structure ready. So I'll just create a div with the class container, which is for the solely purpose to bring it to the center of our screen. And within this div, I'll create one more div with the class loading, where we are going to actually do the animation of loading. So I'll do the CSS in this file only. So between the style tags, first I'll set margin and padding to 0 for all the contents. So I'll do asterisk, and within this I'll set margin and padding to 0. Next, let's start with the container. So we want to bring it to the center of our screen. So I'll just do top to 50%, left to 50%, position to absolute, and transform translate -50%, -50%. So we'll get it in the center of our screen. Now let's start with the loading. So I'll create a border of 6 pixel solid and a light gray color. So I'll give #CCC, and next I'll give a width of 60 pixels and height of 60 pixels. So now if you'll save this, you will get the box on the screen. As we have a box, to convert it to a circle, what we have to do is we have to set the border radius to 50%. So now we'll get it in a shape of a circle. Next, I'll just give a border top color and a border left color to a hex value, which will give it a green color. Now for the animation, we are going to use this animation property. So first is the animation name, so I'll give it a spin. Next is the animation duration, so I'll give of 1 second, and we'll give the animation iteration count to infinite so that it loops forever, and the animation timing function to is in out. So after doing this, we need to set keyframes for the animation. So we'll use this @keyframes and pass the animation name, which is spin. So for the 0%, we will do this transform rotate 0 degree. And for the 100%, we will change the transform to rotate to 360 degree. So after you will save this, you will start seeing the animation. Now this is just a basic one, but you can play around with these things and change some properties depending upon how you want to show the animation for the loading. You can change the animation duration time depending on how fast you want to show the animation. Now if you want it same like I showed you in a preview, where there were a couple of rotations between the starting and the ending point, the changes that you have to make is in the 100% keyframe. So if you change the rotate to 720 degree, then it is going to rotate twice before it comes to an end. So it will look something like this. Now if you want to make the rotation 3 times, then you have to just multiply it by 3. So 360 multiplied by 3, it's 1080. So now it is going to take 3 rotations before it stops and then start again. So if you are doing something like this, just keep one thing in mind. You have to be in a multiple of 360 degrees. Because let's say if I put any random value like 800, then you can see that it kind of lags before it starts again for the rotation, so it doesn't look good. So if you want to go it smoothly, then you just want to keep it in the multiples of 3, and you can change the animation duration depending on how fast you want to do it. So this basically ends the tutorial, and it's quite easy and quite helpful also if you want some loading animation before showing some content.